Well, thank you for joining me for another ITY video. I have with me Jack Sarkissian. He is from Synergy Audio Visual and he is the New South Wales and ACT Area Manager. Welcome to the program.
Thank you.
Now, we are here for the debut of the new Elac range of speakers, but before we do, just tell us a little bit about Synergy Audio Video. As I understand it, it's the premier, or one of the top distributors of top high-end audio equipment in Australia.
Yeah, that's correct. The company's been in operation for about 14 years now. Mm-hmm. We're based in Melbourne. And I take care of all of New South Wales and ACT, so we distribute high-end home entertainment products, be it amplifiers, speakers, quite a number of brands. The origin of the brands are either European or American, mm-hmm. mostly English. We do quite a nice range.
And these are sold at the high-end audio stores. It wouldn't
Very
be the traditional
so.
Computer stores or super stores that you see. These are high-end, which most people would know in the area, which are the stores that sell this sort of equipment.
Yeah, that's right. We only deal with high-end specialist hi-fi stores.
Yeah. So, Elac, this new range has debuted in Australia and came out a little bit earlier this year, but tell us a little bit about the history of Elac and what has transpired to make this new range so special.
Well, Elac is probably about 90 years old now.
Wow.
And they've done quite a lot of things along the way, and not just home entertainment products. They've done a lot of appliances and
TVs
and radios and so on.
But now they focus mainly or only on speakers?
Very much focused on speakers, although they do a range of electronics as well to complement the speakers.
Sure.
The range that you see here is the new range that's just been released called the Debut range,
mm-hmm.
Made originally for the US market. They just recently acquired a new audio designer, Andrew Jones. Some of you may know him from previous postings at TAD, for example.
Mm-hmm.
And he seems to have a knack of getting great sound at reasonable prices.
Sure. So you've got this range here that sits on the shelf, and I can see there's a taller one. So just take us briefly through some of these different models here.
Fantastic, all right. So the range really starts with the bookshelves, the B5s. Basically, it refers to the size of the driver. So mm-hmm. you've got a 5-inch driver with these ones. So these have been reviewed everywhere in the US and Europe to rave reviews. So I don't think there's been a bad word said about these mm-hmm. at all. So the price point starts at $499. And the other speakers you see here are the Atmos-enabled A4 speakers. So these are designed to sit on top of your main front speakers mm-hmm. in a home theatre system.
So if you've got these Blu-ray movies that have the beautiful Atmos sound, this is what switches that on.
That's correct. This gives you the effect of the overhead speakers, so it actually reflects the sound off your ceiling.
Right.
You then have, and these are sitting on top of the F5 floor standers.
Mm-hmm.
So this is their entry point in the floor standard range. So this is designed as your main speakers.
Sure. And is the one on the right hand side, is that the same as the one on the left?
It's the matching speaker, just
without
grill.
Yeah.
So you can see all the drivers out of there.
Sure. And so the one on the right hand side there, is that on the bookshelf, is that the same as the one on the left?
It is indeed.
Again,
it
just without there. The front plate.
That's correct.
And so what are we looking at in the middle here, above the
subwoofer? The middle is the centre channel, or the centre speaker, which obviously is required for home theatre to give you all the vocals.
Mm-hmm.
So not only can you use this particular range of speakers in a traditional stereo setup, but you can also make a full home theatre package out of them.
Like 5.1 or 7.1 or?
Or more.
More,
With Atmos, it'll go up to about 7.4.
Right. And then I can see there's two subwoofers down here. What
are
those
correct.
Two?
That's correct. And again, it can be used for your traditional movies for your 0.1 channel or mm-hmm. your subwoofer channel.
And this one seems to have
also be used for music as well.
And this one has a smaller aperture at the front?
It is. This is their entry model S10 subwoofer.
Mm-hmm.
And basically, it has a down-firing driver with a port firing to the front. Quite a good little subwoofer, $699 price point.
Wow, and the one on the right there?
The one on the right, it steps it up a little bit for Elac. This one has some quite unique features. Now, it is the same size driver, a 10-inch driver in that one, but a much larger amplifier. Plus, it also has a down-firing passive radiator. But what makes this model unique, and also the larger 12-inch subwoofer that they do, so that's the S10 EQ,
mm-hmm.
It has full app control for setting up the subwoofer.
Sure. Have you got the phone in the pocket?
I've left left it over there.
Okay, no worries. Well, I'll hit stop here for a sec. We'll just go and grab it. So we're back with the phone. So just give us a quick demo of the app.
So basically,
just zoom in here.
It is a free app from Elac. So mm-hmm. you can download it for either Android or for iOS devices. I happen to have an iOS device. Mm-hmm. So basically, it operates via Bluetooth. So you don't need any special adapters or anything for this. Sure. It will find the subwoofer once it's connected. And once we're in there, we have quite a lot of different settings. Number one, obviously, being the volume level. So you can increase that or decrease that with a slider. Mm-hmm. And you also do have presets settings for different modes, whether you're listening to music or watching a movie, or quite important is the night mode, which reduces the level of the subwoofer so you don't disturb everybody at night.
Sure.
It does also have an automatic EQ function. So you actually place the phone.
So just show us how you do that. I mean, it's pretty basic.
It's very
you describe
simple.
It. Yeah.
You literally just place the phone in front of the subwoofer within 1 foot or 30 centimeters mm-hmm. for the metric people. It will then measure the microphone of your portable device, because obviously all the microphones are different, so it will calibrate the sound of the subwoofer to the microphone.
Sure, and then once it's done,
we go back to your listening position. You hold it at ear level, or approximately at ear level. Press the button again, and it will then, read all the tones and apply a custom EQ curve to give you a nice flat response in your room.
Sure, and then you were telling me that there's there's even a way to fine tune that even
there
further.
There is. Once it's done all its measurements, and this is one that we've done previously, so mm-hmm. you can see what it's...
One you prepared earlier.
One that I prepared earlier. So as you can see, the blue curve is what it measured, mm-hmm. and the green curve is what it's applied to bring the levels as flat as possible.
Sure.
But once that's all done, you can actually... You can actually go back into it, mm-hmm. and there is a parametric EQ, so you can then fine tune it again.
Sure.
If you find there's a particular boomy sound in the room, you can center in on it, you can adjust the gain or decrease it, mm-hmm. and also adjust the width that it's applied, so you can end up with quite a nice, smooth response. So there's a lot of adjustability with this, and it's a free app, easy to do.
If you've got golden ears, it's made for you.
Absolutely.
All right, well, look, I'm going to hit pause now, and we're going to go out to the other side of the room and have a look at some of the other larger models. So back in a second. Okay, so we're back. So we're in the other part of the room, and we've got a couple of other speakers here. So let's just have a look at those. These are...
These are the bigger brothers of the ones that we saw earlier. Mm-hmm. You're looking at the B6. So it's a larger bookshelf speaker with a 6-inch driver as opposed to the 5-inch on the previous model.
And it's on an optional stand?
It's on an optional stand. These retail at $649. And the stands are $499
sure.
as well.
And what's this, the bigger
And then the bigger
freestanding
one
unit?
Is the largest floor stander that they do in the range, mm-hmm. The F6, and these retail at $1,699. So again, just the larger brother of the previous floor stander.
Sure, and then also there's another subwoofer
there
down there?
The bigger brother subwoofer, the S12 EQ. So again, a larger version of the S10 that we looked at earlier.
And also app-enabled?
It has all the same control app and everything
on that one. Now we also have some of the other products that you distribute here. There's Roark and there's Cambridge. So just briefly tell us about those.
There is indeed. Well, Roark Audio, this is one of their DAB radio units. Mm-hmm. $14.99 is a retail price point, and that's in the real walnut finish.
Yeah.
So it's a DAB radio, it does CD playback, it has FM radio as well.
ABTX Bluetooth.
Yes it does. So you can use it with your smartphone, no problem whatsoever.
Yeah. And it looks very retro and
very retro,
funky.
But it is absolutely up to date with everything.
Yeah.
So quite a nice sounding unit.
Sure.
The electronics we have here are from Cambridge Audio, mm-hmm. And we are using these at the moment to power the Elac speakers that you see on display.
So just briefly tell us what each one is.
At the top here, these are all part of Cambridge's new CX range.
Mm-hmm.
So at the top we have the CXN, their network player.
Yeah.
So it's basically connects up to your internet, gives you sources like internet radio, but it can also stream any music you have stored on your computer or
to different
an AS drive.
Speakers in the house. If you have
this is one room only.
Yeah, okay.
This is one room only. So it's basically an audio file network streamer.
Sure.
It is also a fully functional DAC, so it actually has digital inputs.
Okay.
You can improve the sound of other digital products you have in your room, whether it's your PC, so it has a USB input, but also you can get much better sound from your DVD player or CD player that you have as well via those digital inputs.
Yeah. And then just briefly, the other two devices down there.
Yep. You have the CD Transport from Cambridge, the CXC. This is a digital out only, so it doesn't play back any. It's designed to get the data off CD,
mm-hmm,
and then send it to an external DAC, whether you do it with the network streamer. But we've got it running directly into its partnered amplifier, the CXA60.
And that's on the left hand there?
That's that one.
Yep,
there.
That's
yeah,
that's the amplifier.
So basically, it's a 60 watt per channel two channel stereo amplifier. It has both analog and digital inputs,
mm-hmm,
and that's the way we're using it at the moment. So digital in directly from the CD player and analog in from the network streamer.
Sure. And so that amplifier is powering the bookshelf ones or the big ones?
No, the floor standing speakers.
And is that also going through the sub or just
the subwoofer
yeah?
as well?
Well, let's crank it up and then that's going to be the end
absolutely
of this interview. It's the final thing, the demo.
Remote control.
Yep. So what are we going to be listening to?
We'll be listening to a track from an English band called Crazy Penis.
Yep.
Crazy P is
yep
their other name.
Yeah, sure.
And the track we'll be listening to is Lady T.
Okay.
Oops. Stop.
There, we just...
Stop.
Rewinding, getting it to stop. Well, no, you're not rewinding as such. So just, here we go. From Elac and powered by Cambridge.
Powered by Cambridge.
And looking forward to seeing more products from you in the future.
Lovely. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Cheers.